Speak with Dr. Prabhu is episode 19. So in fact, I want to introduce this speaker. Dr. Prabhu is a medical doctor in epigenetic. Wow, so fast, epigenetic wellness consultant, and he's also a member of European Wellness Academy. Right now he has a clinic. He always give a better advice to his patients. He always explore something, especially the water, because he knows that the water is very important. So he has done some research on the Kangen water, water, etc. Hydrogen water, and now is terahertz water. And why he is willing to share his medical knowledge with us about the terahertz. Yeah, because many people doesn't aware. Many people don't aware about the unique the of this water, no? It really saved a lot of lives. So we also try to get more doctors and to recognize on this. And you look at the Dr. Prabhu, see? He also slimmed down. He himself was using the water and also did some detoxification on the body and slimmed down and looks younger now, right? Yeah, okay, so we proceed. Today's topic is Bring Your Health Revolution through Education. Is it 19? Okay, Dr. Prabhu, maybe next slide.
Yes, very good morning to you, Angie. Thank you very much. It's an awesome morning on a Saturday, everybody. Okay, today, the reason I changed my regular photograph, for you to see that, you know, life is not always being in tie. You know, I wanted to be in a little casual manner, and that's how here. And Angie beautifully well said that I had slimmed down. Yes, my weight from almost 74 now is 65. And it's not just water alone. There are few other areas of correction and persistence with exercise. All these I had to do. And what I did was, you know, compliment every beautiful knowledge which I had gathered along my 32 years of medical experience, and this is what I'm trying to share my customers as well, so that you know they are able to understand our journey much more easily and much more beautifully. So it's not all about just drinking water, or probably you're eating food, or you're vegetarian. It doesn't matter. We have to complement as a whole, then life becomes much more easier. And today's topic, yesterday I decided, okay, there is a beautiful relation, not only internally, externally also. There's a lot of beautiful relations of water between human beings and water. So this is what I'm going to share with you today, so that you understand that drinking water also plays such an important role, because once you know the quality of a water, you will understand what it can do for your body. So here, the first step I would like to show you is, water was first created by the creator. You know, before he could create a human beings or any creatures, it was the water he created. And of course, earth was already there. The earth, nature was already there. But once water was created, then you can see slowly from water. Like if you see a water stagnated in a little place, automatically you see some organisms growing there. It's an automatic phenomena. So water is a necessity for every living being on this planet Earth. Now, the other major thing what the creator did was, he covered the whole Earth, which is just 1/4, the remaining 3/4 of with water. Now, why did he do that? Because it's just like, you know, in a womb, when a baby is formed, it's fully covered by water, because the cushioning effect and the protection it can give for the baby from the external threats is amazing. So that's why if you see right from your the baby in the womb to the water outside, it's doing a great job. And the most beautiful, I don't know how many people of you all have undergone inside the sea, that means scuba dive, I'm talking about scuba diving, or even snorkeling. If you have gone, you would have seen an amazing world which is there inside. Only thing is, most of the human beings, we are only seeing the outside world And whatever we see with our eyes, we see it's so beautiful. Yes, it is. But you should explore underwater. Now, that is an amazing experience. You should try this out. Now, what are the properties of water? If you look at the properties, one of the very important properties, it can clean. Number one, when you drink a water, it soothes you. When you take a shower, it cleans you as well as you feel nice after a shower. Now, flowing water is also very beautiful to see. Have you seen the river water flowing? And it lifts up your spirits. You know, you feel very nice after probably having a shower in the river. And or after a, you know, waterfall, you go have a play in the waterfall and then come out, you will feel very energetic. You know why this is all happening? Because the negative ions which are created wherever there is a flow of water or a flow of energy or flow of air, the ions there, especially in nature, is very, very high. They say near a waterfall, the negative ions almost up to 10,000 units of negative ions are there when you go near a waterfall. Or you go to a nature, maybe a forest where you just go for a walk on a green grass. Now, when you are totally bombarded with positive ions, right from your TV to your mobile phones to all the other electronic gadgets, your body is accumulated with positive ions. When there is a positive ions being accumulated, when you have to create more of negative ions, what happens? Your body tries to heal itself. Now, this is where it's a little different way you need to understand. Being in a positive mind is different from being absorbing the positive ions into your body. It's totally two different concepts. So please understand that. Positive ions have a lot of unfavorable effects on you, whereas being positive in your mindset is a different ballgame for you to move forward. Now, whenever there are water is flowing down from a mountain, and then as it passes, and there is probably a depression, what happens? The water goes and collected and it forms a lake. Now, wherever there is a lake or a seaside, now this gives a cushioning effect or the cooling of surroundings whenever there is a hot spells. This is an automatic phenomena. That's where if there are lots of lakes and ponds, you need to understand that you are Angie, I think you need to mute all. I am going to mute everybody. Okay. Now, other than that, one of the most beautiful part of water, it will take up the shape of whatever the container. You pour it into a glass, it will become the glass shape. So that means there is a flexibility in the water. The property of a water is being flexible. And other than that, if at all, if you see a flowing water and you keep a big stone in front of the water, flowing water, what happens is the water will just go through the side of that particular stone and then move forward. So the water will never stop near that stone and say, who the hell is this fellow who has put this stone? My life is full of a problem because of this fellow, only the big stone is here. No, the water will slowly move to the side and then move forward. So human beings also, we need to take this beautiful lesson from water that whatever obstacles comes in your way, you have to look beyond that and see for solution. Now, other than that, if you see, water will flow to the low-lying area and rest there, Now, whenever you see when the water is resting for a very long time in a particular place, that is when there is a lot of algae forming. There's a lot of other organisms which is being formed there and the water becomes polluted. Now, we also as human beings, what do we do? Whenever there is a lake nearby, our industries and all open all the dirty water, the sludge, everything into that open pond. Now, what happens? Everything gets spoiled. Now, automatically, when the water gets spoiled, of course, the water properties of being clean, whatever the goodness of the water will be lost. So, it in our body also, it does a lot of various function in our body when you consume water. So this is a very, very important thing that water has got so many beautiful properties. I've just put a few things here, but let us go into the lesson what the water is trying to tell us. The lesson water is trying to tell us is very, very important. Water, like a water, you must be pure. Whenever water is stuck, like wherever it begins in a mountain, it's a very pure. When you drink that water, there's a lot of disease healing process which can happen when you drink water from the mountain. Like it can be from the spring, and it can be from oasis. All these places, the water, Zamzam water, can you believe, it's a very pure water, even though it's underground. So like that, the water is so pure. So we human beings also should be pure like a water and lend the purity to wherever we associate. Now the water, when it gets associated with whatever, if it is goodness, it will be the goodness there. If too much of sludge and then all the dirty things there, when the water goes and blends with it, it will become dirty. Now, it is not the mistake of the water. The dirt has been already there, the water goes there. The same way, you and I as human beings, it depends on with whom as you have association. If you have association with the wrong people, you will blend with that kind of knowledge and information. And then that is when you also get corrupted. You also will do all the wrong things under the sun. Today, if you see, because of the Google, the WhatsApp and other situations, you will see that you're getting bombarded with so much of information and your emotion, you get carried away. Why is that? Because when you look at the next thing, we must learn to add value to any gathering by our presence. You know, like for example, you should say, if I am down here, I should be able to give something good to you. You all should feel the goodness. If you have not felt the goodness all the while, you all wouldn't be even coming back on Saturday's morning at 10 o'clock to listen to Dr. Prabhu. You wouldn't have done that, because I'm adding value to whatever I'm doing. Automatically, the world becomes a beautiful place when each one of us take responsibility in whatever little things we are doing and add value. See, add value is a very, very important situation. For you to add value, are you prepared for it? Are you physically fit for it? Are you mentally fit for it? You should create that. Without creating, how can you add value? You cannot add value when you don't have a knowledge, when you don't have a proper information with you. Even for example, if you do not have a proper knowledge of terahertz water and the machine and its property and its company, you cannot just blindly go and tell people that, hey, you drink terahertz water and this is what is the benefit you are going to get. And most of the time, the biggest mistake everybody does in terahertz, what I am seeing is, the first thing they will go down is they will look for diabetic people. They will look for, please stop doing that. You are not a doctor to go and treat a disease. Let's not get into the disease. It's not an area for you. Your job is to share this good knowledge about water. That is it. If the person gets the benefit out of that water, it's amazing. It's very good. But you do not add on to the diabetes and go on telling people that, yeah, this person took diabetes. He's out of insulin. He's out. We cannot go and tell that. The reason is, if you check 1,000 people drinking terahertz water, you will see how many people have improved and totally diabetes out of that situation. We don't know. There might be good number, but we do not know. But before we get all the documents proved saying that, okay, out of 1,000 people, diabetes and drinking terahertz water, 900 people improved of diabetes. That is what we also want. As a doctor, I will ask, yes, definitely, it's fantastic. But until we achieve that, there are a lot of hurdles we all have to go through. So we need to be very careful. If at all you want to add value to people's life, speak in a simple language. Be simple in what? To tell drink water what is a big problem. You can tell them, look, you are already drinking water. What you need to do, just add on this terahertz water into your day-to-day routine. Maybe start little bit and slowly increase it. And then once you find everything so good, then increase the water. So what happens? They also will not jump into the disease part and then try to, what they will do is they will not correlate with the disease. Like, for example, there was one particular beautiful, so 65-year-old man called me up. I said, yes, sir, how can I help you? Now, this gentleman was telling me, doctor, I have arthritis. I asked him, how long you have been having arthritis? He said, I've been having arthritis for almost 20-25 years. He's not able to walk. So the first question he asked me was, doctor, can I get a cure from my arthritis if I drink this water? You know what answer did I give? I was a little rude, but this is what I told him. I told him, sir, my humble apology, please don't buy the machine and please don't drink the water. You know why? Because this gentleman has already put in his mind, he wants a cure for his problem. And this water may not be his problem, giving a solution for his problem, because he's having the arthritis for 25 years. Now, how is it going to help him? By drinking the water, his arthritis will run away, is it? No. And then I told him, I added value to his whatever conversation. Then I told him, sir, you're not wrong. Your expectation is right, because you have been suffering with this particular problem for a very long time. I totally understand. As a doctor, I know that. But in my experience, what I would say is, you're already drinking water, isn't it? Yes. Okay. Now what you do is just add on to your schedule. Probably you're drinking 2 liters of water. Start with 250 ml, then increase it to 500 ml. You try this water for 3 to 4 weeks. See how you feel. You feel good? Go for it. Then later on, you decide you want to buy the machine or not. It's a later one. But the moment you get the something in your someone is recommending you, immediately don't jump into your disease and say you want a cure for it. It will not happen. So always, whenever you're talking to people, please be a little more clearer. And especially, you have to be double careful when people are having problems. You have to be double careful. Why? Because for them, they are looking for a solution. And where, what kind of solution? They want a cure. That is what is every human being is looking for. Now, definitely, it is a good thing that we want to help those particular individuals. But you need to let them take responsibility for their health, because you and I do not know what kind of dirty kind of life they were leading all the while, and what all the diseases they have collected, how is their mindset, what kind of life are they leading. We do not know. We know them as a friend, that's it. Maybe through some acquaintance, we just came in, and that's how we know. And in our happiness to, you know, help the people, because Terraz is doing a great job. So we, you know, jump in there, and then we want to tell them, please take this water, this will happen. Never comment, never commit anything major, especially if people are having multiple diseases, or even if it is a simple disease, just do not come. Do not get involved in the disease management. Do not. But water management, you can get in what? They already have Kove, they cuckoo, all the filtration system they have their drinking water. Yes or no? So what you need to tell them is, already your human beings have to drink water. Add on to this, try it up. How it is, you have to try. Without trying, you will not know. Now, other than that, we must learn to be adaptable and be humble, just like a water. How adaptable? You put water in any container, it becomes in it. It accommodates itself into that container. So this is where you also need to be adaptable to situations. Now, for example, the same person who called me and I told about arthritis. So what happens? You become adaptable to their situation and find out what are they looking at. So you have to have all the intelligence, be humble, and then be informative, so that you give the right information for that, for them to understand that why they should drink water. And in that, why drinking water, Terraz, how it can help them. It can help them in many ways: better nutrient absorption, better oxygen carrying capacity, a better viscosity. So what happens? There's a lot of good benefits you will get. Now, after drinking that, you're going to get some benefit for your diseases. Why not? It's a beautiful situation for us. It's like, you know, before you build a house, what can you talk about the house? You can tell, my bedroom will be so beautiful. I'll be under the shed, under the roof, and I can be prevented from hot sun and prevent from, you can talk 101 things. Until I build a house and go and live there only, then only I will have the benefit of having the shade and prevention from the sun and from rain. All this will happen when? Only when I put my foot and build a house or go to a house. So everybody should get inside there. Without knowing, getting inside, you cannot go outside thinking, oh, it is going to be like this. This is going to be, with high expectation, do not go inside. So you all need to have openness in your mind. That is when you will be able to get inside, get the benefit to the best of your abilities. So do not have any kind of unnecessary negative thinking about any situation, be it water, be it food, or be it anybody recommending something. If they recommend, what your job is to receive the information, analyze it, and then you, what you need to do is, you need to experiment it. For example, someone will come and tell you, hey, this restaurant is very good, why don't you go and try this food? Yes, you can go and try. But what happened? To your bad luck, on that day, the cook was in a very moody way and he prepared the food very wrongly. So what happened? The taste may not be good. So what happened? You went in. But can you go and tell your friend that, hey, you recommended me that restaurant is so lousy, the food is not good? So one man's meat is another man's poison, you know. So in that way, for one person, it might be good. For you, it may not be good. So all depends on individual. Now, water by itself can never get contaminated unless we contaminate. Very simple, right? Now, when you're born as a beautiful child, you're unpolluted, right? Your mind is very clean. Okay, when you see, especially when you're as a baby, very clean. When you go and talk to a child, the child will never, like for example, if a thief goes and talk to a child, hello baby, how are you? The, what the child will say, hey, I'm very fine uncle, how are you? Maybe it'll rebel. Now, if you and I, the same thief comes there, what will happen? The moment he comes in only, we will know, oh, this fellow is a big thief, you know, and we'll going on telling everybody, hey, this fellow is a thief, la. You know what, he has done this, 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 and then we'll build up the so much of negativity against him. Why? We are prejudiced always. We live in duality. When you live in duality, always it is a good or bad. That's it. You have never neutral life. Whereas babies and children, until the age of 5 years, they are beautiful. They are like God. So what does it mean? If they are like God, means what? They are neutral. That's it. You don't have goodness or you don't have badness. It's all we who have created it. So in our life, you don't get contaminated by the information what is flowing in and around through Google, through what people are telling you, what you hear say. Do not listen and get contaminated. Very, very important. You should have a filtration system in your mind. What is right? What is wrong? You should have a filtration system. People can tell 101 things, but you have to be a little careful, especially when you're handling your situation so that you don't get contaminated. Now, many times, whether you like it or not, we get contaminated a little bit. It's still okay, no problem, but you should clean the contamination, right? So that is where your mind cleansing also comes in. So that means you need to have a positive attitude. So you need to have a few positive people in your life, even though you may have a few unfavorable people in your life. Have some beautiful souls in your life, wherein when they give you all the positive things in life, pick it up, cleanse yourself, and then start moving forward. Now, we must use water very, very sparingly. This is a very important information I want to share, because in the next 25, 30 years to 50 years, the water resources will be depleted. Why? Because we human beings are multiplied to 7.5 billion. This earth doesn't need 7.5 billion of stupid people here. It doesn't need, but who bothers? Your job is you get married, you produce. This is what we are all doing. Human beings have no other business. Our procreation, what God created was for procreation. That means you create one like you. But you have made it like a recreation here in this earth. Producing children like recreation. And what happens when you are having so much of so many human beings? From where are you going to produce the resources? You find it difficult, isn't it? Now imagine you are in a poor country where you don't even have money to buy food. What will happen? You will see, like in Africa and other underdeveloped countries, people are children are dying. Whose fault is that? Who gave birth to the children? Why the parents didn't have the senses? And today, from here, all over the world, what are we trying to do? The children are starving. Who we have to donate? Yes, we let us help them. But did that human being have the courtesy of thinking, should I produce a child? Nobody is thinking of it. Why? Because we don't even have the added value to our own knowledge. What is necessary for us? Can we do it? Can you believe, once we produce a child, we are committed for 20 years, 20 long years, your life you have to spend for them. So you must think, if you have 5 children, 10 children, what is happening? It's a burden on the parents. And by the time you're 50 years, how much of money you will have? Now, this is where your mind also will tell, go do this, go do this. And this is where all the money game comes in, and everybody wants to jump in and make more money and then become rich in no time. Now, do you think all this will happen? No. Now, can you believe it? Just recently also, I was discussing and I was telling, AirAsia, what happened? Last time, every now and then you can listen to Tony Fernandez's name coming there very frequently. Now, what happened? Nobody is even talking about it. Where is he? What is he doing? Nobody knows. Now, how much of difficulty he must be going through, how much of pain he must be going through, how much of losses, how is he managing? We do not know. A beautiful soul, of course, there was a lot of good things happening, but suddenly what happened? Everything turned down. Like this, life can go up and down. So we all need to be very, very careful. And water plays such an important role in our life, because in the next slide, I'm going to tell you how water plays such an important role in our life. Okay. Now, it begins in the mountain and reaches the sea of infinity. Now, just like water, we are born very pure. As a baby, we are pure. Now, at the end of the day, when you die or when you leave this planet Earth, we need to go and get merged with the universe of sea, which we call it as God, which we call it as a heaven, which we call it as a home of God, which we call it as a Lord's home. This is what we are all talking about. It is a sea. It's a sea of bliss. We have to go and reach there. So just like a river, when you started like in a mountain, then you have to go to the sea of infinite. Infinite is what? There's no limitation. Once you reach the God's lotus feet, everything is unlimited. And this is what people are telling. I do not know, because I have never been to heaven or I have never died to go and see whether where is God. I don't know. But the reality is we all feel one day we have to go back there. No, other than that, can you see water is used to douse the fire, right? The fire engine, when there is a fire, what happens? He comes and then uses water. So water can actually subside your fire element in your body. Now the fire element is what? In my next slide, I'm going to share. In our body also, water elements is related to Hara chakra. For such of those who know about healing and the body chakras, there are 7 chakras in our body, and Hara chakra is just above the root chakra and below the Manipura chakra. Hara chakra is related to the water. Now, water has emotions. Just like water, our emotions are also volatile. So hence, balancing our emotion plays a very, very important role in our life. Balancing. So if you go into the subtle energy of whatever the energy treatment, people would like to balance your Hara chakra. That is when you become much more balanced in your thinking pattern, thought pattern, then automatically you will be able to move forward. For example, why emotions are so volatile is, for example, we are just having a discussion and suddenly one person say, "You stupid fellow, what are you doing?" And there is some argument going on. What happened? Your emotion starts building up. Now, if you do not know where to stop your emotion is what? Energy in motion. Okay, it's moving. If you give energy of positivity to the motion, there will be positiveness. If you give negativity to the motion, there will be negative emotion. Very simple, right? So you need to understand as a human being, what emotions are you giving it? If it is building up with negativity of hatredness, anger, greed, lust, no good at all. So you need to cut down that emotion, create more of love vibration, yes, positive vibration, so that you get balanced in your life, so that that situation doesn't become so volatile that there is a disharmony happening in that situation. For this, water plays a very important role. So other than that, our life also began. Now, this is a very, very clear picture I'm going to give you. Please understand, we all began with the union of two souls. Only when our parents united together, there was a heat involved. This is a heat, you know, the fire element inside the body is triggered. The desire, the heat was opened up. Now, what happened? Finally, when at the end of all the fire, what happened? There is the fountain of life coming out, the sperms, your life. Millions of sperms came out, right? Now, after that, what happened? There is only one sperm which actually fertilized your ovum, and that is what you are. Can you believe you are born on this planet Earth after fighting with so many millions of sperms who also wanted to go and fertilize the egg? But it didn't happen. Only one sperm, that is you. You are a human being today, right? So isn't this a beautiful life that you are here? And when you are born as a winner, why in life you are all struggling to say that you are a winner all the time? Why do you get involved with the situations of difficulty and all the situations where you find it difficult that you are not able to see success? Why? And God has given you 6 senses. You are much better than an animal. But as a human being, why do you have to, when you have won the war and the battle in the womb of your mother, and then you are born here as a human being, what other success can it be greater than being a human being. Isn't that beautiful? So from today onwards, look at that beautifulness of what God gave you as a beautiful soul to be born here. That's the only gift you can appreciate. The moment you appreciate that gift, everything starts falling in place. So change the way you are thinking from today. Other than that, your body, of course, everybody knows, we also same like the earth, 70% is water. So that means majority is water. So how clean is the water in your body? How clean is your body? So this is very, very important, isn't it? So what kind of water are you drinking? Are you drinking the water like terahertz has all the good properties of water? So good enough. So when you drink this water, so what will happen? There'll be a lot of added value to the existing water, and slowly all the poison which you have consumed and which you have been consuming all the while, slowly it get cleansed up. Over a period of time, you can become a beautiful soul. Why not? Give it a try. It can take 2 years, 3 years, 5 years. It doesn't matter. But be persistent for you to move forward. Now, water retains energy. That's how all religion uses the water to bless and sprinkle around, isn't it? Like Hindus go down to Ganga water in India to get bathed. And you go to a temple, of course, they give something called Tirtham, the sacred water for you to drink. If you go to a church, they will bless you with water. So there are a lot of beautiful things, because what happens is when you bless, or when you chant a mantra, or when you chant good things. For example, very simple is you hold a glass of water and you chant the mantra, I love you. Simple, you know, just say I love you to the water. 9 times, and you try drinking that water every day, you will see that in 21 days, there is a lot of changes happening inside your body. Why? Because when you say, I love you to the water, the love vibration is inside the water molecule, and your water retains that energy. Now, for example, you're the same person holding a water in the hand, and that moment another friend comes in and they talk about something unfavorable, you know, about another person who is totally negative, who is a thief and who is doing all the wrong things under the sun. So what happens? You are actually talking about that person and you are holding a glass of water and you're talking about that person. What happens? Your water is absorbing all those energy, you know. What? You're talking negative about that person and the water is absorbing. And then what happens? You talk all the negative things and you drink the water. So did that person whom you're scolding, it does go and affect him as well. But who is affected first? It is you who are affected first by drinking that water. So what happens? You should be so careful that especially if you're having water or whatever liquid in your hand, you better be careful and then be very clear what you're talking. If a discussion is all very emotional with negative emotion, don't drink the water, don't drink the coffee, don't drink the tea, because by doing that, you're poisoning your body indirectly. And then later on, don't come and tell, doctor, I'm drinking Tara's water, but nothing is happening, doctor. Why, doctor? Sorry, huh? It is you who have created that. Nobody else created that, because you are the one who think negative, talk negative, and then ultimately put everything inside your body, all negativity, and your body is filled with negativity. Now, who is responsible for that? It is you are responsible. So what do you do even today? Change. It doesn't matter what. You have a beautiful journey ahead. Start from today. Start from today. What you need to do, send a lot of love vibration. At least be smart, especially when you are around with water, food, drinks, anything, be positive. Don't think negative, don't talk negative, and don't talk unfavorable words at all. You should not. Why you should not? Because you don't poison yourself. Please, don't poison yourself. So this is a very, very important instruction. You need to be very careful. And that is why, especially, there's a lot of good practices, even in Hindus and in Christianity. We all do, what we do is we bless the food, and we bless the water, and then we eat the food. What happened? There's a lot of positive things going on. But you bless the food, and after blessing the food or the water, you start eating and then talking about some other person, negative and unfavorable. What happened? Once again, you're blending with the same negativity. So cannot. This is where we always advise, whenever you're having your food, please do not listen to your phone. Do not attend your phone. Do not watch television. Especially if you're watching television, any movies which has a lot of negative emotion, please do not watch. Very, very important. Have a peaceful time only for food. 15 minutes, please. 20 minutes, please. It's your time for your body. Please understand, this physical body, if it is not there, you're a dead person. Don't live a dead life on this planet Earth. Let's all live a life of full of joy and bliss. This is a blessing to you, and it is in your hands. It's not outside. Now, another very important, water has memory. So be careful in what you curse and what kind of negativity you're using, especially with other people talking negative about others. Be very careful. Sending lot of love vibration is the best to augment the water power inside your body. So be a smart person. Don't be a dumbo doing all the wrong things and then expecting the right result. It will never happen. You want good things, you change. You want the good things to happen in your life, you change first. You change your thought patterns, you change the water molecule, you change the water memory in your system, because 3/4 is your water wire. What kind of memory the water has picked up from you, nobody knows. It's only you should know what all you are talking for the past whatever number of years you are living on earth. Are you complimenting or are you complaining? If you are a complaining person, let me tell you, your life will be full of complaints, your life will be full of problems only. Be it the best of everything. Even if God comes on and gives you the best thing in your life, you will not change. Why? Because you have tuned your life like that. Now from today, what happens? It's a beautiful opportunity. Why not? Change. This is what you needed. So change and give more of positivity to your whatever you are doing in your life. Be it terrace water or be it embrace water. It doesn't matter. Whatever system you have, be happy in that and then move forward. All right? Now, another beautiful thing, water can be mixed with anything. You can make coffee, tea, mix it with milk, you can cook rice, you can make sambar, you can make whatever, kuichua, whatever you want. You need water, isn't it? Now, can we not human beings just like that mix with every beautiful human being on this earth? Why are we separated? Either we are separated by a caste, creed, religion, we are separating ourselves for what? We all are the same. Then why should we separate ourselves? And say, okay, claim I'm so and so, my religion is so and so. So what? Do you know that how much ever you claim, whether you're a Hindu or a Christian or a Muslim or whatever religion you came, at the end of the day, when you are being go and burying in the earth, does the earth will tell you, hello boss, you please come and bury only the Christian here, only the Hindu here, only the Muslim? No. You take a Christian and go and bury him in the Hindu cemetery, the Hindu cemetery will accept him. Why? Because they don't have a religion. Then why is that we are all so much very important for us? You know, when we die, we have to be buried only in a Christian cemetery or a Hindu cemetery or a Muslim cemetery. Why is it we are, why, when God never separated us from anything? Can you believe the oxygen what you are inhaling from the air? Did God create a situation where, okay, this is only for Christian should breathe this, Hindu should breathe this, and then Islam should? No, he has given the beautiful oxygen everybody should breathe. Then why are we separated here? God never separated water, God never separated the earth, God never separated the space, God never separated the air. All these when he didn't do, who are we to separate what he created? We have been separating ourselves, and not only separating ourselves, what are we doing? We are fighting with each other for who is greater and who is bigger. No, we all have to change. Become so beautiful. Let's all blend here. We have come here with one purpose. We have to live here peacefully and die peacefully. This is what is we all want. Let's be as one human being, live a beautiful life. We have nothing better than that. But at the same time, when you see, water will never mix with oil. It will never mix. So when you pour oil also, the same way, there are sometimes you will see that we may not be able to blend with all the human beings around. We cannot. Some people are like oil. They'll be so thick, you know, you tell them anything also, they'll be the same. So we can't. So what we need to do, don't mix with them. Come out and you start moving forward. Why do you want to talk about them? It's none of our business. So we also should know, like water, what is not cannot be blended. Please don't go and blend. All right. Now, other than that, water, very important. You have seen the calm sea? So beautiful. We can go and play in the water there. The waves are so beautifully lashing on the shore. You can swim there, you know, play all the water sports. All can be done. Just one trigger of earthquake under the sea, you know, what happens? A tsunami can come. Once a tsunami comes, what happens? You have to run for your life. This is what is happening. What? The same calm water, it changed. Now in the same way, your emotions, the energy in motion, if you get angry, what will happen? There are every chance it leads to destruction. So this is very, very important. You should please rethink. You want to become angry, what happens? But if anger becomes a rage, it's like tsunami. it's going to cause destruction. Have you seen people in rage? They will throw things out, they will break things out, they will do any, they are mentally sick people. If a person throws things on the other person, or if he is in rage, does all this, you would have seen even in the road rage, right? People coming and banging your car and doing, they are all mentally sick people. Now, how are you going to avoid these people? You and I cannot go and change them, right? But when you are in that humble, calm emotion all the time, you will never encounter such people in your life, because they can never come. Your vibration will never attract them in your life. By chance, you are going that way and someone comes and dashes you. What will happen? Because you are so calm, you know, you will never get excited at all. What will happen? Now, recently this happened. I was in my condominium. It was night, 8 o'clock, and I am reversing my car. Normally, when I reverse my car, of course, I'll give a little accelerator. And incidentally, that day, my vehicle was not moving. So I had to give a little more accelerator so that it goes. So I gave a little accelerator. And the next thing I noticed was there was one car behind in the darkness. I didn't see. Went and banged, you know, dumb. I just heard a noise, bang. That's it. I come out and see, I've gone and banged. My is a Mercedes, an older version. It went and banged that car. It was a Serena car. The door all went inside. That lady driver, she got panicked and she came out and said, she shouted, "What? You don't even see the vehicle and you come." Then her husband came in and then they started. It was in my condominium. Huh? So what I did, I was very calm. "Sir, I just took my hands like this. I'd say my humble apology. I didn't see you. I took the reverse." And you people also, they could have seen my vehicle coming reverse, but they didn't also see. It's okay. So now I said, now already it has happened. What do we do now? "You please talk to me tomorrow." That's it. I never told anything. I gave my card and I said, "Please talk to me tomorrow." So the next day morning, I still had time what I can do. You know, we still have 24 hours time to decide what we want to do. Then I calculated and then he called me up at 10 o'clock and I said, "Doctor, what happened?" I said, I was very open, you know. I said, "See, I don't mind paying you 500 ringgits if there is any repair charges to be done for vehicle." You know what he said? "Sorry, doctor, it will take around at least 2,500 to 3,000. Then I said, "Okay, fine, no problem. Come, let's go to the police station. We will lodge a complaint. I'm paying insurance. You please claim the insurance. I have no problem. But I won't be paying you 3,000 and all. That's no way." Now, worst come worst, what will happen? I went to the police station. I lodged a complaint. Now, there we both are discussing, you know. He was telling me, "Doctor, you know, your NCB next year and all, it will be taken out. You know, you have to pay." I said, "I'm paying only 125 ringgit for my the old vehicle as an insurance. That's only the amount I'm paying for my insurance. Now, 3,000, the company is going to pay me. What's a big deal? For next year, maybe it will say, please pay 200 ringgit. So what? I'll pay 200 ringgit. It's still okay, but I'm saving another 2,800 ringgit, which I need to put from my pocket, isn't it? Does it make sense or not? Okay, forget about the 200. Next. Of course, when you go to the police station, when you give a complaint, what they will say, who's at fault? He said, "You're reversing the vehicle. It is you are at fault. Finish." So what he told me, "Doctor, you have to pay me 300 ringgit. That's a fine I'm going to put you. Summon." I said, "No problem. Please give the summon." Can you believe I went and paid 300 ringgit immediately? The whole matter got settled. Finish. Now imagine, I could have fought with those people the same night. "Hello, you are in my condominium. How the hell you should have seen like this? I was taking reverse. Why you cannot see?" We can argue. But at the end of the day, it doesn't work. So what happens? You should know how to control your emotion. Please be very careful, especially when you are speaking to other human beings. Be calm, and you have to handle your emotions very, very beautifully so that you are always calm. For that, you need to every day practice calmness. Every day practice to bring down your emotion to a very lowest level of just in peace, just in bliss, and start moving forward. Don't get excited. It's okay. Someone will come and talk to you. "Hey, this steroids water can do this, do that." "Yeah, thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. It's fine. No problem." Then what happened? Then take all the information, collect it, then speak to your whoever you feel that they are important to you. Speak to them and ask more information. And once you are convinced that, yes, this can do something good for you, please go for it. So it's always like that. When people will give you an option with, of course, their what intention they are coming, we do not know. Whether they are coming with the intention of just helping you or with the intention of selling one device to you, we do not know. But at the end of the day, it's you who have to be very smart. You have to be very clear in what you want. It's not that just because someone comes and tells you that you buy a device for 4,500, you need to buy, not necessary. Why? But if it's a good investment, why not? You should. 4,500 is not a big deal. If you look at this beautiful body, now what is the value you're going to do? Maybe $1 million. So what? If it is $1 million product, can you not put to 4,500 ringgits for that body and then buy the instrument? Why not? We can buy your house. It'll be 200,000. So for your body, water to terahertz it, you just need to pay 4,500. It's still okay. So like that, you need to know assessment has to be made. So ultimately, it's you who have to decide what is the value you're going to give. If it's good, worth it, please. It's not that only rich people have to buy the same products, 20,000, 30,000. There are a lot of products available. But what is reachable for you, go for it. Now, at the end of the day, you all have to drink water. You should drink water, isn't it? So what you need to understand is we all have to have a standard quality of water. Number one, pH. Maximum 7.4 to 8 pH is good enough. Now, if it's 8.59, it's still okay, no problem. It's good. But other than that, your total dissolved contents in the water must be around how much? 50 to 200 is good enough. For this, you all can go to the Lazada and buy all the pH meter, TDS meter, and ORP. You all should have one. All of you, if you are doing business, please buy this testers. Keep it with you all the time. Test the water. And especially people, when they bring their own water for terahertzing, you better check all the quality and then only you terahertz. Because sometimes if the TDS is very, very high, for example, 500 and all, you better don't terahertz them, because you're going to create more poisoning for them by doing resonating the water with terahertz, especially if the TDS is around 500 plus. It's not good. So you better be careful in that. ORP, what happens if the ORP, of course, one thing you should understand in ORP is oxidation reduction potential. It's like, you know, there are a lot of thieves in our body. When the thieves are there, what you need to do, you need to donate one molecule of oxygen, because these thieves will go on stealing your oxygen molecule. So what happens if your ORP is high in your body, it will donate one oxygen to the cells, which are looking for cells, because they'll be telling this fellow has stolen and gone, madam, the free radical damage. They have taken and gone. So what to do? They'll be waiting for one more oxygen. If for too long you don't give that one oxygen, always if you look at oxygen is O2 is two molecules, right? If one oxygen molecule is stolen, only one oxygen is running around. So what happens with one molecule? The chances of this particular molecule becoming cancerous is very, very high. Now, when the cancer is high and when they start multiplying, normally cancer cells starts growing in an anaerobic atmosphere. Anaerobic means there is no oxygen. So who is responsible for that situation? Of course, we can tell genetic responsibility, we can give food, everything we can give, but at the end of the day, the oxygen molecule is not there. So can you give a little extra molecule? That is what is this ORP. So ORP can be there in your vitamin, your free radical damage prevention can be done by taking antioxidants. So when the ORP, like if your pH is around 9, like in ionized water, if your pH is between 9 to 9.5 to 10, definitely your ORP is minus 300, minus 400. And such of those, you are using bamboo salt here. I would like to share 1 teaspoon of bamboo salt. When you mix it in water, the ORP can go up to minus 400. But the ideal around 200 will come minimum. If you're taking half a teaspoon of bamboo salt, mix it in water, the ORP is minus 200. That means it's going to do a lot of good things when you're drinking the bamboo salt. So it becomes a medicinal salt if you're taking bamboo salt 6 burn. If you're taking 9 burn, amazing, because that have a much more higher oxidation reduction potential. Other than that, the water must be very clean, free from bacteria, viruses and parasites. It should be clean, very, very important. So your filtration system, as Angie was telling, the filter given by our company is good enough. But the problem in Malaysia is, let me tell you, within 15 days, that whole filter becomes brown. What to do? So every now and then, of course, we use the salt paper which the company has given, clean it. But by the time you clean it 4-5 times, the whole candle becomes so thin that it'll break. So automatically you need to buy a new one. It's still okay, but definitely you need to have a good water filtration system outside your house and one inside your house. Please invest at least average of 1,500 to 2,000 ringgits for having a clean, safe, potable water, number one. Number two, then if you have the terahertz unit, and when you terahertz it, definitely that's a better way for you to drink, drink that particular resonated water is definitely better, and it should not contain any heavy metals, toxic metals, chemicals and pesticides. This is very, very important. So you need to see to that you drink, have an ideal drinking water first before you even look for terahertz unit or MRET technology or ionized, whatever it is. Look for an ideal drinking water first so that you're rest assured that your body gets the best of water, which is 3/4 of the content in your body, right? Now, this is going to be the future, definitely. Of course, there can be another technology coming in the next 3 to 5 years, better than terahertz. We do not know, because science has been evolving a lot. So in that way, let's for now understand that terahertz technology is the latest one. It is doing very well, and there are a lot of good safety measures in this, and that's where the water resonating has become such a big hit in Malaysia, and then we are all able to enjoy it. But at the same time, we need to be a little balanced in whatever we are doing, because definitely you drink more also, there can be some negative effects, there can be some unfavorable effects can be there. But still, I would say ideally if you can drink around 2 liters of water is good enough, because definitely resonated water is definitely a good structured water, is good for our body. And the same way we have ionized water, magnetic resonated water, ozonated water, then we have structured water. There are so many other things in the market. If by God's grace that today someone is talking to you about terahertz technology, you decide. If terahertz technology is good for you and you want to go for it, go for it. In the same way, this universe is so big one. Definitely another person will come and talk to you about ionized water. Up to you. You decide. If ionized water is better water, you go for it. It doesn't matter. Ultimately, you decide what is best for you. But today, let me tell you, definitely in the present situation, with all this water around, this is the easiest. Within 3 minutes, you can get the water resonated. This is amazing. Definitely in the future, probably in 3 seconds, the water can be resonated. It will come. That is just the water goes inside and comes out. You go hold it in a mug, already you get a resonated water. It can be the future. But structured water, now the most beautiful part of this terahertz is it is stable for a very long time. And the other day, George was telling me that they have tested until 1 year, and the quality of the water is still the same and the properties are still the same. So that's a good news for us. So there's a lot of goodness and good things happening around with the terahertz, and a lot of people are getting the benefit, and be it a normal human being or be it disease with the diseases. And there are a lot of good things. So the best thing is when good things are happening, it's all our duty to see that, get the good things to you as well and see what benefit you can get. Now the properties, this once if you understand this concept, life is more easier for you to move forward. Now, your job is to explain to the people that just tell them the properties. Do not become a doctor and treat the diseases like as I'm telling you before. A diabetic will come to you and definitely say, will my diabetes get cured? Please tell them, you are not a doctor and I'm not talking about curing of a disease or a healing of a disease. But you tell, this water has got these properties. Now in these properties, there are every good chance that your disease can be come under control, number one. Can be cured, I do not know, but it can happen. So what are the properties? Number one, it can be boiled. If you're talking about ionized water, the moment you boil, it loses all the properties. So what is the big deal? Whereas here, you boil the water, it still retains the properties. That's one of the very good. It has got a longer shelf life. That means you can keep it for a long time. Now, have you seen anybody coming and selling you ionized water? They will bring it in a full black container and say, you cannot expose it out. And maximum within 1 day, you have to drink it up. It can be even to the hydrogen water, which is quite familiar, and a lot of people are selling the hydrogenated water right now. Hydrogen water is also another very popular right now coming in. Now, you ask them, what is the shelf life of hydrogen water? They will tell you it's a very short life. Now, when you have a short life, that means you have to drink it very fast. You create it and drink it up. That's it. So that means the shelf life, if it is longer, is it better or not? Of course, on one side, it's better. But what I would say is, even that, why do you want to place it for 1.5 months or 2 months? You prepare it every day and drink it freshly. Advantages for you, isn't it? That too, if you have a unit, buy it. But if you don't have a unit, it's still okay. Buy it in a 5-liter container. After resonating, pour it in a 5 liters, or take 10 liters of water, keep it in your house, finish it in 1 week. It's it's okay, what? At least 1 week, it's still okay. No problem. I have given for people after 1.5 months also, still the water, I see the, hydration of water I tested, it's still good. This is still the same. And there is one beautiful thing what is happening. Of course, this is the information I picked it up from other sources and I'm sharing it with you. And what I feel is our Terra's water also can do this. What is that? It helps your DNA to rectify the wrong epigenetic gene expression. See, for example, you have too much of positive ions. Positive ions, I'm speaking once again, positive ions in your body. Now, what happens, like even radiation, it comes in and it will give all the wrong signals to your DNA. Saying that whatever the situation is, that it will create some wrong signaling to the gene expression, wherein your DNA will read it wrongly. The moment it reads it wrongly, what will happen is the DNA will manifest it. It expresses it in the wrong way. So for example, if you're eating the wrong food, what will happen is you will have a big paunch, right? A big belly. What is happening is it's all the wrong information which has been fed to the DNA, and the metabolism will change. Automatically, what will happen is definitely you will face some problems because of that situation. Now, like problem is what? You can, once your stomach is becoming big, your metabolism is slow, diabetes can come in. Just give me a minute. I need to switch on my, I'm just switching on my laptop. All right. Okay, I'm sorry. So the DNA part, I was telling you, it does can help. So when you're drinking this water for a long time, maybe around 3 years, 4 years, you're drinking this water continuously. So there can be a change in gene expression and then you can become much more healthier. Now, these are all, they have done testing in the MRET technology, which is a magnetic resonance. They have already done all the research, but the molecular structure of that is 7.86 and the molecular structure of Terra's water is 7.6. Not much of a difference. So what happens? There is a lot of good things when it can do, 7.6 can do definitely the same thing. This is where I am able to understand that this water also can do a lot of good things to our genetic makeup and then the expression. It can definitely do, and then we have to give it a try. Now it's too early for us even to tell whether any DNA changes has been done. But what I feel is in the past 6 months after drinking this, there's a lot of good things happening. There's a lot of beautiful energy within me. There's a lot of good things there and out there, even to my people. When I give, all my people are very, very happy. In fact, I'm handling one of the most complicated diseases like polycystic kidney with ready to go for dialysis. But for the past this is the fourth month, the person has not gone for dialysis, and then they are still drinking Terra's with other supportive measures from my side. They're doing very well. So they are very happy. But at the end of the day, I wouldn't know like how much, but 4 months not going for dialysis itself is the biggest challenge which we have overcome. I believe by divine grace, probably this patient will not be going in for dialysis. I wouldn't know, but I still pray and then assist them with all my positivity that she should be healed and then move forward. But the complication is this particular person bought the Terra's unit when I said it's good, even though they were so poor, but still they bought the machine and they are using it. And the other sad part is her whole family, like father, mother, brother, sister, grandfather, all have the polycystic kidney problem and all go through dialysis. Now her brother, sister, everybody are in dialysis. Only she was supposed to go to dialysis, but now she just came to me. So I only hope that she doesn't land up in the same bandwagon as their family of only dialysis. So that's on one side. Now, other than that, the molecular size of the water is so small, 2 nanometers. So what happens? Better absorption. So when there is a better absorption, that means your cells are working much better. So BMR is what? Basal metabolic rate. So every body cell has to have a basic metabolic rate, especially if you're having thyroid, hypothyroid, your basal metabolic rate will be slow. So when your basal metabolic slow, what will happen? You will put on weight. You will feel lethargic. You'll feel lousy, you'll feel like sleeping, you'll feel tired. All this will happen when your BMR is low and your liver is functioning low. Now, when you drink the water, what will happen? It increases the metabolism. So, as I always say, if 50 cells are working under the low basal metabolic rate, and when you drink Terahertz water, it goes and remaining 50 cells, it activates as well. So that means 100 cells are working. So if 100 cells are working, what happens? The basal metabolic rate will increase. If the basal metabolic system increases in your body, what will happen? If 50 people are using glucose in your blood, is there glucose, is there, they are eating it up. Now there are 100 people, 100 cells, they are also want to eat the glucose. So what will happen? Your blood glucose will come down or not? So what is the big deal? Why are you people excited when people are coming and telling you, oh, my diabetic has come down? Who did that job? It is your cells are doing the job. Have you ever thought of it? Your cell is so intelligent. What? When you give the right thing to your cell, the cell will know what to do. The cell is so intelligent. And you have how many cells in your body? 50 trillion cells. Now 50 trillion intelligent cells are there in your body. And why not you understand that? Give them the right food, give them the right water, give them the right intention, give them the right energy. Everything will be fine. Don't you think? 50 trillion intelligent cell universe inside your own body, and you are such an intelligent being, then where is the problem? If your body is not responding to you, that means all the cells have become dumb, they have become stupid. That is why they are not able to rectify the problem. So what you need to do, be smart, become intelligent by feeding your cells with all the positive things. So not only positive things, the right water, the right nutrients, everything plays a very important role. Please do that. Now, when you drink Tara's water, resonated water, what happens? The angulation opens up. What is the angulation? How many of you know that there is an angulation of water? The H2O angulation is something like this, 104 to 109, but ideal is between 106 to 109. If your water molecule is probably the size of the angulation is around 102, 103. When you do resonation with Tarahaj, it will open up by 5 degrees, 3 to 5 degrees. Now, if it open up 5 degrees from 105, how much is it? It goes to 110. Or 104, it goes to 109. It's good enough, isn't it? 106 to 109 is called as live water. When there is a live water, there is a lot of healing happening inside your body. Is good or not? So that is where the hardness of the water is reduced. When the angulation is opened up, hardness is reduced. Other than that, what will happen? Whatever food you eat, there's a lot of minerals. Minerals are very, very important for your body. Even though they're all micronutrients, they are very important for you. Other than that, it has got an anti-radiation. That means you're using a phone. When you're drinking this water regularly, it protects you from the radiation to a certain effect. Now, how do you prove this? People who have gone for radiotherapy, cancer people or cancer treatment, and when they are consuming this water and then they go to radiotherapy, when they go to radiotherapy and come back, their healing process is much better, much faster from a person who has not taken the resonated water. So there is an advantage there. Then it has got an antibacterial effect. So that means when you're drinking this water, all the E. coli and all the bad bacteria will die and clear up. So we need to have good bacteria, right? From where the good bacteria will come? So you need to eat, drink yogurt, number one. Number two, kefir, K-E-F-I-R. You can prepare, a lot of people out there are selling that kefir because it contains a lot of probiotics. So when you consume a lot of probiotics, your gut is so healthy. When you keep your gut healthy, let me tell you, half of your diseases is gone. So you need to detox regularly. You need to give your body a lot of probiotics. All these, when you give, what happens? When your gut is already healthy, your diabetes get cured. Your diabetes can get healed. Your blood pressure can come down. Your sleep can be better. There are so many benefits you will get. Your immune system. Now with COVID situation, your immune system needs to be better, isn't it? So for that, you need to have your gut very, very clean and healthy. And it is not a one-day job. You have to continuously 365 days make your intestine healthy by eating the right food at the right time, at the right place, with the right attitude. Definitely your gut system will be very, very healthy. Other than that, beautifully low viscosity. This is another thing. It's just very slippery. I always give low viscosities. All your new cars and new engines, aluminum engines. And what is the viscosity? It's a very, very high viscous. So what happens when you use that engine? The engine totally, there is no noise at all. And the vehicle is smooth, the torque is much better, the pickup is much better. So the same way you think you are a vehicle and you are taking the fully synthetic oil. It's like fully synthetic oil. When you consume fully synthetic oil, what happens? Your cells are happy, They are able to slip and move on. This is what you can see, especially when Eddie is doing the blood test. You should see, you know, after drinking the water, what will happen is Eddie will say, wow, 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 see there how it is moving, you know. And not only Eddie will be amazed to see, but I would, it is so nice to see the people seeing, yeah, my cells are running, you know, they are, it's jumping in joy. This is something so beautiful. It's all because the high energy in it and the viscosity all plays a very, very important role in our body cell. Now, other than that, it has got an antiviral, antifungal properties, antioxidant, and the linear arrangement means they're all arranged in one line. It's beautiful. That means entering into your aquaporin is much more easy. It's like, you know, there is a single door and a group of 10 people want to enter. It is difficult. Instead of that, make them in one line and ask them to go inside. It will be so easy to go inside and come out. The same way, linear arrangement is much, much better. So what are the benefits you're going to get by drinking the Teraj Retinol? Definitely healthy cells, better cellular function, better control of disease, detox naturally, illness to wellness will happen, high energy of cells. Overall, you'll feel energetic. Now, on the right side, you see, maybe, this is, I'm very careful in this particular wording. Please note, maybe benefited in diseases like diabetes. Yes, you may be benefited. Maybe your sugar level is much better. Fantastic, isn't it? Maybe your blood pressure is going down. Fantastic, isn't it? Maybe your heart issues is much, maybe your pumping capacity was a little low after drinking the water is much better. Well, why not? Kidney diseases, maybe your kidney issues which has been there, much better now. Your kidney function is better, good or not. Your uric acid is coming down, why not? But it may not happen because I am having one person wherein his uric acid is not coming down. So this is where I need to look at a little more bigger picture. Genetically, is there any problem there? We have to look at different situation. Chronic long-standing arthritis, maybe the pain because of the viscosity, maybe the joint gel and all is increasing after you drink this water. So thereby arthritis is also coming down. Why not? Post-stroke patients after a stroke drinking this water because the blood flow is much better by after drinking this water. So they are feeling much better. The recovery is much better. Don't know. Better, isn't it? Especially people having a lot of toxicity. When you drink this water, it detoxifies. But I would say all depends on individuals. Hence cannot be taken as a gospel truth and treating diseases as there is no clinical study on this. So better what we need to do is it is the individual, how they are, we do not know. If it benefits, we say praise the Lord, hallelujah, fantastic, it's good. Why not? But I would say, let's be a little cautious in telling people with diseases so that they don't claim or blame you that it didn't happen or something wrong had happened. It's always better that we play a safe role. Drinking water is no poison, but you can drink water, isn't it? So start with a lower dose and then increase it. So what is the final message is you have to have a balance of life. Balance is the key. This is every time I'm going to tell the same thing because balance is what we want. You see the balance, if it is a same like equal 50-50 equal, you are happy, isn't it? Why? You go buy 1 kg tomato. 1 kg tomato is 5 ringgits. You pay 5 ringgits, he gives you 1 kg tomato. If the balance is more on the weight side, for example, 1 kg is lower down and little tomatoes on the tomato on the other side is up. You think you'll be happy? You'll say, hello, boss, you have to put one more tomato, you know, it has to balance. Yes, but we human beings are so smart, you know. When the weight goes up and then the whole weight of the tomatoes come down, we are very happy because it's overweight. Maybe 1 kg and 100 grams extra. But our mind is so happy. Will you tell the shopkeeper, hey, no, take out the tomato, give me only balance. No, isn't it? But that's, we are all human beings. We are happy what extra they give, we take, bring it. But in reality of life, we all should have a balanced lifestyle. That is when things will be much more easier. And what is the message I wish to give you is water is a beautiful just as you are. So you are made up of water. So become beautiful just like water. Be adaptable, be human, be kind and be compassionate and use it very sparingly. At the same time, drink sufficient amount of water to be hydrated well inside your body cell. Maximum I would say is 2000 is good enough. The remaining part of it, drink the normal water. But other than that, while drinking Teraj water, do add on with a little bit of salt, a little bit of bamboo salt, a little bit of ORS. All these can be added, tender coconut. These are all supportive measures you need to do so that your body doesn't lose all the potassium, sodium and all, and then you feel the cramps and pain in the body. So just balance it. And people with long-standing diseases, just be double sure you're guided properly. This is what I would request you all. And be balanced and move forward. Don't drink water to cure disease, love, please. Your mind is wrong there. You have to drink water to survive. That is what is important. Without water, you cannot survive. Without food, you can survive without food, but not without water. So drink water to hydrate. Do your best and leave the rest. So hydration is your main focus, you know. So be smart. Hydration is your main aim in your body, not to cure your diseases. Who invented diseases for you? It is you who created the diseases because you didn't take care of yourself properly. So now just by drinking the water, don't make the water that it should come and cure your diseases. It won't happen. And please ask, avoid asking whether this person can drink water, especially with disease. This is every day, you know, I'm getting calls asking, doctor, this person is having this disease. Can they drink this water? I'm fed up of answering many times. I feel, hey, water is water, love. What is the big deal? Now, what you need to do is start with lower. I always say you have to give it a testing time for your own body. Or what I would say, you go back and see for the past 15 years or 20 years, what have you done for your own self? How many positive things have done? What are the diseases you have accumulated in the past so many years? If you have collected all the disease, then you are at fault. So you have to change. So do not expect the water to come inside and change your disease. It is not going to happen. You need to change from now. Take 6 months time. Change your attitude, change your food habits, change your drinking water. All these, okay, even if it is a normal drinking water, is it a clean water? Is it a water with all the potable water are you drinking? We do not know. I see many of the people don't even have a proper filtration system in their house. Then what's a big deal? So what are you talking about terrace water? You can first make sure that you drink a normal healthy water. Then we can think of added resonated water is a little luxury for us. So you need to be a little more careful in whatever you are doing. So first make sure your drinking water is clean first. Then you can add on with the terrace water. Now, how many of you are taking bath in terrace water? Not many of us. But why not? You should try. I have tried it. It's fantastic. Now, other than that, use it on your pets, use it on your plants. There are a lot of other benefits you can do. You can resonate even oils, you know, you can, your cooking oil can be resonated, but don't tell me buy the 2 ringgit 50 cents oil and then you resonate, but definitely it will do good. But first of all, I don't advise you to use the 2 ringgit 50 cents oil, because have you ever tried put your hand inside that oil, take out and then use a soap to clean? You know how much of soap you need to clean that, and imagine you're frying your chicken, mutton, everything in that and then eating the same. So how many of you have seen in the Pasamalam, they are using all the high grade fantastic oils? They all are buying the 2 ringgit 50 cents, and some people are so stupid that they go buy the recycled oil. There is another group of people, they go to the restaurants and whatever the cooked oil, they will collect it and they go recycle it and then put it in another can and come and sell it as that recycled oil. Some nonsense is all going on. So please spend a little money. If it is for your cooking, go for some good oil, like pure groundnut oil is available. All like olive oil is good. Your coconut oil is good. Grapeseed oil is good. Bran seed oil is good. So it all depends on what you want in your life. So you need to spend a little money on your food, wherein you buy certain little good things to your life so that you don't accumulate all the poison inside your body. And you should go and experiment on yourself. Life is so much of possibilities. There are so many things happening in this beautiful world. We all live only once. Let's take it as a challenge. Experiment it. I am a person like that. I will go experiment it. I try it. If it's good, I'll take it. If it's not good, I'll just remove it and move forward. That's it. I won't blame anybody. Because blaming anybody doesn't give any kind of solace to you. Unless you are a person with negative emotion, then you will feel very happy. You know, another person dying, you will feel happy. Another person having a problem, you will feel happy. There are a lot of people like that, but that is not a good emotion. Always you should feel happy to every soul, whether they are suffering or we should share a helping hand to them and then see what best we can do. So with this, I think this is what is the final information. What I wish to every one of you is, if there is an option for you in your life, go for scuba diving. If there is an option available, go to the water under the ocean, sea, go and see. It's an amazing. And do spend time once in a month, go to the seaside, spend time in the water there, enjoy. Go to the riverside, enjoy there. Go to the waterfall, enjoy. So these are all, water plays a very, very important role in making us happy. It's a beautiful journey we all have to. So enjoy every moment of life and then start moving forward. And looking forward to see you all again with a new topic. And I think I've taken 1 hour and 10 minutes. It's a beautiful time. And I think you all gave me this wonderful opportunity. I never expected that I would be speaking 1 hour because my slides are very few. I thought I'll finish it in 30 minutes, but it has gone to 1 hour, 10 minutes. And I thank you very much for this wonderful opportunity. Bless you all in abundance. And until I come back and see you, have a fantastic week and have a beautiful, positive emotion with a positive attitude in every cell of your body, with 50 trillion intelligent being inside you. Create a universe of your own self. It's a university you have in your own body. So you can do a lot of good things in your life. Go with it. And until I see you back, I will be taking leave because 11:30 a patient is coming now. So I need to take leave. So thank you all once again. And until I meet you, have a great day.